Tesla has been a leader in the development of a car with self-driving capabilities.
But testing that autopilot car has been fraught with problems and at least two deadly crashes. Now a consumer group is demanding tougher, safer standards. KCAL9's Elsa Ramon is live in Santa Monica tonight with more on Tesla's testing problems. Elsa.
Well, Susie and Jeff, Tesla has wooed customers and investors with the idea of having an autopilot car. But local consumer watchdog groups say these autopilot cars need way more testing than they're getting, and that people are going to continue to lose their lives.
The dash cam records the very last seconds before the Tesla Model S, said to be on autopilot, violently slams into a street sweeper that was barely visible to the human eye on a Chinese highway. The 23-year-old driver was killed. In May, 40-year-old Joshua Brown was killed driving his Tesla Model S on autopilot in Florida. The car's sensors failed to distinguish a white tractor trailer from the sky, propelling Brown into the semi.
What's really troubling is we're learning about the defects of a self-driving car, not from Tesla, which knew about this, had to know about it because it's connected via computer to all its cars, but instead from the Chinese media.
Consumer watchdog group's Jamie Court says Brown's death in Florida in May was widely believed to be the first death involving Tesla's robot car technology. But Court says the accident in China happened in January, and Tesla didn't reveal that information that could have saved Brown. He argues the lack of federal safety standards is allowing Tesla and other companies who want autopilot technology to use drivers as guinea pigs.
We need a separate roadway if we're really going to test and develop these cars that's separate from the rest of us. That's a lot of infrastructure. That's something no one wants to build.
After the accident in Florida, Tesla said in a statement that drivers acknowledge the system is new technology and still in a public beta phase. Drivers are told to keep their hands on the wheel and that, quote, you need to maintain control and responsibility for your vehicle while using it.
Well, you don't call a device autopilot if you expect people to put their hands on the wheel.
Court says this disclaimer doesn't absolve Tesla of the responsibility of using technology that hasn't been safely tested, and that we are likely to see more deaths due to Tesla's lack of transparency.
But when you have human drivers and robot cars that don't detect hand signals, that don't do well with potholes, that don't do well with street sweepers in a lane that aren't obvious in the fog, we can't deploy these vehicles without safety standards.
I reached out to Tesla today to get comment about the accident that happened in China, but so far, Susie and Jeff, we have not heard back from the company tonight. Back to you.